You can speak now to France 24's film critic, Lisa Nesselsen, to get her lowdown on it all. Lisa, No Man's Land, first of all, the big winner, taking a lot of the major prizes there.
Well, yes, it gives journalists something to write and talk about. That Chloe Zhao is the second woman to win Best Director and Best Film. That's after Kathryn Bigelow for The Hurt Locker in 2010. But I don't believe that gender has anything to do with excellence. While others are celebrating the doubling of that figure, all the sexist, xenophobic bigots out there must be very peeved that a woman who's an immigrant and from China has triumphed in this way. Frances McDormand winning Best Actress for her role as a widow who takes to the road admits her to a very exclusive club of people with three acting Oscars: Walter Brennan, Ingrid Bergman, Jack Nicholson, Daniel Day-Lewis, and Meryl Streep. Only Katharine Hepburn has ever won four. And in her very short acceptance speech, McDormand told people to go to movie theaters and seek out the biggest screens they can find, and when it's safe, sit side by side, shoulder by shoulder, with other people to watch together.
Meanwhile, Lisa, talk us to some of the other notable winners. There were some surprises, Anthony Hopkins, but also there appeared to be a lot of diversity.
Well, a lot of people who placed bets that Chadwick Boseman would win a posthumous Best Actor Oscar for his role as an ambitious horn player in Ma Rainey's Black Bottom lost money when, as you said, 83-year-old Anthony Hopkins won for his performance as a proud man sliding into dementia in The Father, French playwright Florian Zeller's first try at film directing. Zeller shared the adapted screenplay trophy with Christopher Hampton, and he said that he wrote the part for Hopkins, who he believes is the greatest living actor. Also, speaking of people who have been at it for a long time, veteran Korean actress Yoo Young-yeon, she's been on screen for half a century, gave an adorably frank and entertaining acceptance speech for winning Best Supporting Actress in Minari. She said, "I don't believe in competition. How could I win over Glenn Close?" And she said it must be an extreme form of American hospitality to hand out awards to Koreans. Close, by the way, has now been nominated 8 times and has never won, which is a pretty good illustration of just how silly the Oscars really are. But she's a superb actress, Oscar or no Oscar.
Okay, so you're saying they might be a bit silly, Lisa, but nonetheless, what were your highs and lows for the ceremony?
Oh, there were quite a few moments I liked. Harrison Ford, before announcing Best Editing, he took a folded sheet of paper out of his coat, and he said he'd like to read some viewer comments that had been submitted after a sneak preview of a film he appeared in. And they were all negative or insulting, complaining that the story was confusing and stupid. And then he said, deadpan, that film was Blade Runner. All-around great entertainer Rita Moreno announcing Best Picture after Brimming with False Modesty, pointing out that, 60 years ago this October, West Side Story came out, and it went on to win 10 Oscars, including Supporting Actress for her. This telecast was the first time the trailer has been shown for Steven Spielberg's remake of West Side Story, which was supposed to come out last year and is now slated for this coming December. Incredibly peculiar was the decision to put Best Picture before Best Actress and Best Actor. Usually the show leads up to Best Picture. That's what we're used to. I don't think you'd put the last chapter of a book before the end. Zhao, by the way, said that she and her father used to recite poems together, and one she liked translates as starting with, "People at birth are inherently good," and that she has always believed in those 6 words. Tyler Perry, the powerhouse independent actor and director who built a studio in the South that employs thousands of people, was the winner of the Jean Hirschhold Humanitarian Award, and he urged people to refuse hate. Whatever the situation, whatever they throw at you, refuse hate. And then Daniel Kaluuya won the Best Supporting Actor for playing Illinois Black Panther Party leader Fred Hampton in Judas and the Black Messiah. He's an Englishman, but his American accent was spot on. And he said that life itself is just incredible. My mom, my dad, they had sex, and now I have one of these. It's incredible.
Lisa Nesselsen, thanks a lot for that wrap-up of the 93rd Academy Awards. We'll have to leave it there.